Hey guys, here's the video. Today I'm doing Heavy Labor, the second figure in TFC Toys' Hercules, I guess, series, basically. This is the second guy after Excrever, and the packaging, really quick, is very, very similar to Excrever. Try to kind of find it. And you can't see a whole lot. I am looking into getting a wide-angle lens for this. It's just, I don't want to have to modify the iPhone a lot to use it. But you get them together. Packaging is very similar. And it helps if you get them lined together properly. But there's that. You go on the back, same deal, and all that kind of stuff. Simple packaging, but it does work rather nicely. You can see Heavy Labor in the back through the clear there and on the front. So there's all that kind of fun stuff. Get the guy back out. Get him ready to go. He also does come with, like before, instructions to get him into his vehicle and his limb mode, and a little bio card or a tech spec card. Very similar to Excrever, and this is kind of to show you what happens when you have cats in the house. Brand new card, nice and shiny, looks great. After the cats have found it, and have played with it, and kind of ruined it. But, you know, they're all together, you can compare there, compare the little tech specs. I'm not sure if this one was always this light compared to this, but it's possible, I suppose. This one does seem kind of lighter, but there's that. Yeah, there's that. And here we have Heavy Labor, or the not Heavy Load. I think Heavy Load's his name. I hope Heavy Load is his name. If not, then, well, I'm sorry. And he is kind of simple. He's about as simple as Excrever was, but I don't know. The transformation for him just seemed like it wasn't quite as advanced. I don't know. I can't really put my finger on it, but he just felt kind of simple. They are roughly the same height, with Excrever being maybe a hair taller, and that's just a very, very slight difference. If you look at them dead on, side by side, they are extremely similar in height. But they just look good together. I was kind of worried, and it's a stupid thing to get worried about, but I was kind of worried that the colors would be off for one figure versus the other. So you'd have one guy in this green and one guy in kind of more of a yellow. It's a stupid thing to be paranoid about, but it's a gamble to get these guys. These guys are $100 each. It's a gamble. You're going to worry a lot about this. But you can see all this little silver detailing. It is carried over here. You can see his legs. He has nice little silver bits there on his shins and his hips and just all this really nice little detail thrown in. The prototype images had this part, I think, completely empty with green, and it just looked weird. But having all this painted on detail makes the figure pop extensively. I am hoping that at some point we'll have a repro label set for him. I know there's one out for Excrever already, and it makes him look a lot better. I do plan to get it, but I'm kind of worried. If you're buying these sets now, how will it impact the overall combined mode of Devastator? Because that's how a lot of us are going to have ours displayed. So I'm kind of waiting for the stickers. But there they are together, and here he is on his own. This is his video. It's all about him today. He does come with the Energon kind of weapon and the purple paint of it. From what I have heard, these are going to combine to make Devastator's giant cannon when they're fully combined. All the smaller weapons will be able to peg together and make a giant cannon. I hope that's true. I don't know. And apparently this is meant to be in its like powered up kind of blasting form. It's energy form. So, but you can take those. And like Excrever, you can have them pegged in behind his arms there. And this one kind of goes off at a weird angle. It's got an odd little slot to it. This one doesn't really seem to have. This one, you kind of put it in, and it goes anywhere. But you can't have him like that. And I really don't mind that storage. I think it works pretty nicely for him. You can have it going down, but it kind of gets caught with this little bit of his arm, so it kind of pops out. Or you just take him off, put him aside somewhere else entirely. It's all up to you. Articulation-wise for him, the arms have full rotation. They can swing out to the side fairly far. And due to this transformation, you kind of have this little bending motion here. So, really nice movements. I do like it. Rotates at the elbow, bends at the elbow. And again, from his transformation, the wrists can kind of move, but it's not anything really special. They kind of sink in when you're transforming them. So, I wouldn't really call that much articulation. The waist has nice movement. The legs can go forward pretty far. And they can go back just as far. The really cool thing is when he's in his Devastator form, he is the lower torso. He is the top of the leg. So his legs can go pretty far forward, and you do have to kind of move this little piece out of the way to get him going all the way. But you go to the other side, he has a very similar kind of thing there, where the legs can go as far that way as well. So articulation-wise for his legs, he's got a lot of it. He can, of course, swing out nice and far that way. He can rotate above the knee. He can bend at the knee. And again, from his transformation, the toes can move, but they're kind of not really ratcheted, but there is enough kind of a friction there. You can have his toesies pose in a variety of ways, not to look all transformed. And again, just that silver paint adds so much to this toy. Like, if he didn't have any of this detail, it would be a very bland toy. It wouldn't have a lot of fun with it. But all of this detail really does make it pop and shine. You can see even just a little bit on his cab section. It just brings a lot to the figure. You go to his head. It's not on a ball joint, so he can't really look up and down, but it can rotate left and right. My only real complaint with this mode, or with this figure overall, there's a lot of loose pieces here and there. You go to his head, and his head seems kind of bobbly. Well, when you transform it, this little piece comes down, and there's nothing really holding this in place. This just pops out, and it I don't like that. I don't like it just moving around so freely. You go to his his bed section. I don't know what it's called, truck bed. It's just very loose. I would like for this to be able to peg into something, and from what I can see, it doesn't. I've tried to have it up here, doesn't go anywhere. Down low, it just kind of goes. It just kind of does that. You have to kind of get this angled properly so it has enough move there. But the slightest turn, and it moves. The same thing with his limb mode. His little covers here, they're just really loose and flimsy. I want something that's gonna hold. It's annoying. It is. But that's it for his robot mode. Does look quite nice. Now, two transforming into his vehicle mode. Kind of like Excrever, you can get him into his limb mode pretty much directly from his vehicle mode. So I'm going to do the vehicle mode, then the limb mode, and all that kind of stuff there. You're going to start, fold his toesies up, and then take these little pieces here, the, I guess, lower parts of his legs. And they're going to fold up. Make sure you have this held securely at this knee part, because they're going to fold up at this bottom joint there. And give a little push. This one, it really kind of clips in place. I'm not sure if it's from friction or not, but this one has kind of a harder time. But this side, same thing. Apply pressure to the knee so you don't move it, and then slide that up. And it's going to fit like that. That one did as well that time. There's that. Now, make sure I get it right. Yeah, that's right. Because see, for his limb mode, you have it like that, and that adds a lot more bulk to it. And you can see that's going to be a massive cod piece when it's done. But there's that. And that's basically done there. Now go to his arms. You're going to take the fists, rotate them inwards, and then this little piece is going to slide out and tab into this little groove. You may want to try to get it where this is up a little higher so you can just slide it down, but I find it's easier just to get that and then push it in place. I have a little worry of that tab breaking off at some point, but the quality on this guy feels as good as Excrever, and in my opinion, it's as good as an actual Hasbro product. It doesn't have that kind of flimsy plastic that we have sometimes with Fans Project and other third-party stuff. But again, maybe that's just me. So now you're going to take this, rotate it around, and you can see how it's going to line up, how there's all this little detail. And when that's there, that's going to come across. And actually, I'm sorry. That's going to line up that way. I got a little confused by all this stuff. But anyway, line it up again so those are there. Slide this down, and there's that. Yeah, getting there. But that's going to come down up here, and the head's going to fold away. Goes inside, goes up, and the whole bed section is kind of probably the hardest part, in my opinion. You're going to have this side slide up like this, and if you look inside, there's a tab there, or a peg, I guess, really, and there's tabs all through here. That's going to peg into this hole, that's going to tab into that slot, and then these are always kind of iffy, where those two go on the underside, and that just clips together all weird, but so get that, and then the hard part, because again, I'm paranoid of these breaking off, so I got to be really careful, but when you're done, you just get that going. So repeat with this side, get that tabbed under there. See, that one I always have a little bit of trouble with, just a little bit, but then once it's done, just squeeze it all together. There's that. That's going to go over like that. Last but not least, fold up the leg portions, and there's little tabs there, little slots there. Sounds like it's cracking, but that's just the ratchets and everything. Get those tabbed together. And when you're done, you get that one little side in. This window is being difficult for me. But there you go. So there's that. There is heavy labor. I keep trying to tap the toy when I'm trying to focus on it. That's goofy. But he does feel really small. He has a really small vehicle mode. He does roll pretty nicely. The wheels get caught occasionally, but it's not really that big of a deal. He does have these little details painted on the side. I do wonder what these are going to mean. I'm sure there's some Transformers expert who knows already, but I don't. That is my phone ringing. And even though he is kind of small, you put him next to Excrever, and they fit and scale perfectly, at least going by the cab section. I'm assuming that's how they would go. I have not seen them in person, but just by the cab section, they feel like they are in scale together pretty nicely, and they just look good. I mean, these guys, they're not like perfect classic versions of construction vehicles, but they are well enough that you can tell these guys are Constructicons, and that they're kind of in that classic style, and I do like it quite a bit. Just all the detail on them both just really, really shines and pops, and it just looks great. Of course, you can take the weapons, and like Excrever, peg his up top. Now, those I really had no problem with. I thought those worked, oddly enough. But if you go with him, his I don't like as quite as much. They peg in at this kind of weird angle. I'm not sure if they're meant to be not so much exhaust pipes or smokestacks, but they just don't look right to me. I'm not a fan of how those fit in, which is kind of odd, because those are clearly just guns on the back of the vehicle mode. I don't mind them. You could say this kind of an attack mode. These are cannons that can fire. You know, maybe if you kind of rotate these around, we could have some better luck with it. But the instructions have them like that, and I'm not a big fan of that. I don't like how it looks. It would be nice if you could move the actual truck bed in this mode, but I really don't think you can. I don't think it's possible. But overall, I really do like it. It does feel small in your hand. It really does. But the overall bigger picture is this is a Devastator, so it's going to turn into one eventually. So let's go ahead and put it in its limb mode, shall we? I think we should. Let's take these away. Get those there. Now, he's pretty much already in his limb mode, to be honest. All you do, you unpeg those little sections back there, slide the legs back down like they were for robot mode. And it's just really tight joints. So there's that. Rotate that around. And that's going to go down like that. And there you go. There's his limb mode. I wish I was joking. It is very, very, very simple transformation. But you have to remember, he is the lower torso. All this guy has to do is have legs that move. And if you get these out of the way, see, these are just so loose. You have to kind of move them forward and then get the legs can go along with that way. But since he is basically the lower torso, he doesn't really have much of a purpose. What is kind of cool, though, and this may be just my thinking here. If you get the instructions out, they actually show how he's going to combine to the upper torso. Which, I know, we've already seen the full toy, but it's just nice having just a little image of how it's going to work. Oh, and also, for his combined state, that's going to, you know, go down. There's a little tab inside, so it's probably going to be something kind of like that, I would assume. But yeah, it's weird, but I like having this little graphic picture of how it's going to fit together. You can see those little tabs, or those little slots that are going to hold in the top portion. And I really do hope this thing turns out as nice as we're expecting. But for one final comparison, here he is with the arm that'll be in place. And it's hard to get a nice view of these because I don't have a wide-angle lens yet. I really do want to get one at some point. But you can get an idea just how big Devastator is going to be. This is just a lower torso, remember. There's going to be a chest portion going up top. So he'll be roughly kind of like that. It's going to be a really nice Devastator. I'm really excited for him. But TFC Toys really planned this kind of devilishly. You know, they're releasing all of these figures and pieces that we can't combine them yet. I forget what the next limb coming out is going to be, but I just want to have these combined somehow, just sitting somewhere waiting. That's all I want, really. Now, there is one more thing I should probably mention. I'll just get him kind of properly like that. A lot of people have had issues with Excrever's arm breaking. And I can see how. This little joint here is very, very stiff. And I've seen a lot of issues with it, like, cracking. And it's hard to even turn without it actually pegged into something. I mean, it's a very tight joint. Very. And it's cracking all through there. Now, TFC Toys said they were going to release a new arm, which they have. This, they didn't have to do this. This is excellent customer service. I really do like this. You open it up, and it's the exact same arm from what I can tell. The only difference, go ahead and get that off, is if you look at the actual base, and I don't know how this is going to show off. I really have no idea. But this is the new arm. They've made this piece a little thicker on the side, and they've made the overall ring thicker. So I'm trying to think of the best way to get this shown off here. I don't know if I can really... You can't really see all that well. But if you just look closely, they have made this one a lot thicker, so it shouldn't break. The exact same arm, everything still moves, and this is still as tight as it was before. Just, I haven't had any issues with this cracking yet, but I have seen others who have, so it is nice that they've included this. From what I have been told, they've included this with every release of Heavy Labor. So if you haven't even gotten this guy yet, and you're waiting to get him later on, you should get the new arm with Heavy Labor to replace the old one. Mine hasn't broken yet, but it's nice to have this replacement in case it does break. So, excellent customer service on their part. TFC Toys, I think, is really winning me over, and I can't wait to have more of these guys. I really want to have Devastator. So, I think the next release is going to be either December or January, probably a little later. So it's going to take a while to get all this done, but it'll be worth it. I think this is an excellent purchase for you if you are a Transformers fan, if you have the means to get it. You want to have a nicely sized Devastator that's not going to cost you $3,000 and you have to repaint it at some points, I would say go for this. This is an excellent little deal. And, well, not really a deal, but it does look nice. My only complaint, really, with this is, and I meant to mention this earlier. If you look at his legs here, see, this one doesn't really stay in all the way. This one, it locks in place nicely. This one just kind of pops apart, which, not a huge deal, but it is kind of annoying. And it's just been staring at me the whole time I've been doing this. But that's all I can really say, guys. So, I hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.